Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. I'm Nicole Chantel, and if you like beauty videos, 31 days of Halloween, and Friday vlogs, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button and become part of my makeup family. With all that being said, let's jump right into this video. Loves. Today we are going to be talking about my February favorites of products that I cannot stop using. But first, I just want to say thank you to each and every one of you who have sent in a testimonial for me into the Sephora Squad influencer program. I'm so grateful to each and every one of you. Thank you for your love and support. If you guys haven't already, I will leave the link down below for you to go to fill it out for me. But once again, thank you so, so much. So now with that out of the way, I'm going to be talking about products that I can't stop using. Like I'm just totally obsessing over. We got some drugstore, some high-end, so it's a mix of everything. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is a face primer. Surprise, it's not the Tatcha Soap Chemist Primer, which I'm totally obsessing over, but this one here, I cannot stop using. I've been using it every single day of the week, and it's by Annabelle, and it's called the Refreshing Perfecting Primer, and it's enriched with caviar, lime, pearl, extract. Yes, I did say lime and I did say caviar. But anyhow, when I seen this into my local Walmart, I said, this looks very interesting. I took the tester, I swatched it, and you could smell lime. Like at first it's like, oh my goodness, really strong. So I didn't know at first if I was going to be able to get it because I'm so super sensitive to scents and it gives me a really bad migraine. So if you're anything like me, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But when I swatched this on my hand and I started to rub it into my skin, it actually like faded, like the fragrance faded, and my hand looks so beautiful. I was like, okay, let's get this. It's under $10. I actually did a video using this primer. I will leave the link right here for you guys to check it out. And it says, apply the Refreshing Perfecting Primer in a thin layer, and it hydrates your skin. Wait a few seconds before applying foundation so that the wear and the freshness and the brightness of your makeup would be maximized. And I have this on today underneath my foundation. This here, what they say is so, so true. It just glides on the skin so nice. It definitely brightens my skin. I feel like it makes my foundation look a lot better and actually makes it last longer, exactly what they say. And I guess it's because where it's enriched with caviar, lime, pearl extract, so I'm assuming that's the reason why. But I so love this, and it is beautiful. And I do apply a thin layer like they said, and it just comes in a little squeezy tube. I don't even know if you guys are gonna be able to see the color of it, but it is kind of yellow. But once you apply that into your skin, it just melts into your skin. What a difference. I'm telling you, like I said, this has replaced my Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer. That's saying something because I'm totally obsessed with that primer. But for the quality and the price of this primer, beautiful. It definitely gives that gorgeous finish to my foundation. Absolutely love it. And also on days when I don't want to wear foundation, I just want my skin to look really nice and bright and soft, I pop this on and out the door I go, and my skin just looks really beautiful. So the next product is a foundation, and I really didn't know if I wanted to mention this foundation because it only comes in 4 shades. Yes, 4 shades, so that is so disappointing. I actually used it in the same video as the primer, so you guys could go ahead and check that out and see how it applies. But as you could tell, it's on my face and it's gorgeous, but it's very disappointing that it comes in 4 shades. So I hope that Essence, yes, Essence, I really hope that you guys come out with more shades in this foundation because it is beautiful. I have been like leaving my YSL All Hours foundation, just letting it take a break, because all of February I've been applying this on my face. Even before February I was applying this on my face. And it's the Essence Fresh and Fit Awake Makeup, healthy glow with vitamins, complex, and cranberry water. I did get the shade Fresh Ivory, which is number 10, which is the lightest shade in this for me. I normally go for porcelain, like in my NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop foundation. I did get the shade Light. Was the light in that one or porcelain? So anyways, I go for lighter porcelain. So this was the lightest shade that they had there, which was number 10. Like I said, Fresh Ivory. I have it on my face today. This applies so gorgeous. It is very nice and lightweighted, and it definitely gives me a beautiful full coverage, I feel. Here on the back of the bottle, it says it has vitamins 3, E, and B5, cranberry water, medium to high coverage without mask effect. So it definitely doesn't give me a mask effect. It's not like cakey. It doesn't crease on my skin. It blends so gorgeous. But like I said, the only downfall is that it has 4 shades. So Essence, please, please come up with more shades in this foundation because it's beautiful and it's under $14. Like I only paid $12 and change for this. So really super inexpensive as well. Next, I have a setting spray, and it's the Milani Make It Last setting spray. I absolutely love this stuff, love it so much that this is my second bottle. What I like to do besides setting my makeup with this spray, I actually take my eyeshadow and I dip it into like glittery eyeshadows or shimmer eyeshadows first, and then I go ahead and I spray my brush. Some people spray their brush first, then dip into the eyeshadow, but I find when you do it with this spray, it almost like leaves like a weird film over the eyeshadow, so I don't like doing that. I like to dip my brush first with the shadow, then go ahead and spray it, and it makes the shadow so super vibrant, really, really gorgeous. Really love this. I really prefer this like over any high-end setting sprays. I've tried a few sample high-end setting sprays, didn't really like them, just that no good. But this here, love it. So if you guys could get your hands on it, I definitely recommend this setting spray because it is my favorite. Next up is eyeshadow palettes, and I have not one, not two, but 3 eyeshadow palettes. The first one I absolutely love, and it was a gift from my mother. It's the Huda Beauty, the Nude palette. Love this palette. I actually did a Valentine's Day look with this palette. If you guys would like to see that, I will leave the link right there for you guys to check it out. Absolutely beautiful. These shades blend gorgeous. They are super pigmented. Really love the concealer in this. I love taking the concealer, applying it to my lid, and then I always set it with the shade Beer, which is this beautiful nude shade in here. Great, great quality. I just am obsessing over this palette. I try not to use it too much because, you know, I could kind of just keep on constantly using the same eyeshadow palette. So that's why there's 2 other eyeshadow palettes in this video, because I've been using those. So I kind of rotate. 1 week I'll use this, then I'll go to the next one and next one. But really love this. If you guys have been wanting to try it, go for it. I actually compare the quality of this just like her mini palettes, which I really, really like. I didn't really like the rose gold first one. Did not like that palette at all. I found those shadows super drying, but these shadows in here aren't drying. Whatever it is that she put in this, she made the shadows beautiful. Absolutely love this palette. And the next palette is by Dominique Cosmetics. Just look how big this palette is. It's like bigger than my face. Anyhow, I did do a look and I did post it up on Instagram. I'll pop up the picture here. I absolutely love this. When I seen this pop online, I was like, okay, I knew I had to get it because the shadows in here are so gorgeous. Really, really beautiful. It comes with a full-size mirror and the shades in here are just so pigmented. Just really soft and gorgeous. Like, I love this purple shade here, which is called Bittersweet, and it's just beautiful. So, so stunning, really nice and creamy and soft. They're just an all-around great matte eyeshadows. Really love the quality of these. You can pick this up online at Sephora. And if you guys haven't tried it, I definitely recommend that you should. Really just all-around great pigmentation. They blend really nice. I was really impressed with the look that I did. I really wanted to go in and do a purple look, but I was like, Nicole, let's go outside the box for a moment. Stop doing purple eye looks. We know you love it. So when I did do it, I used the shades Cherry Juice and Chocolate Mousse, which here's Cherry Juice right here, and here's Chocolate Mousse right here. And they just blended really gorgeous. And then I went in with warm, then I went in with Warm Pie right here, which is a beautiful shade as well. All around, really super impressed with this palette. Like I said, it's a big palette. It is gorgeous. Definitely recommend it. And this palette here is by Quo. And Quo is sold here at Shoppers Drug Mart here in Canada. And this one here is called For the Love of Makeup Palette. Can we see how big this is? This is a big palette as well because it's a face palette. You have your eyeshadows here and then your face products right here. I love the contour shades in this palette. This is the contour shade that I use right here, and I also use this blush. These two here are the 2 shades I am constantly going into this palette. It was limited edition for Christmas time, but I do believe that you could still get it on Shoppers Beauty Boutique on their website. But all in all, really great palette. I did do a look, but I didn't post it. I wanted to play with the eyeshadows. And the eyeshadows, they blend really nice, really great quality as well. Now, I did pay full price for this palette, which was like over $50, and now it's on sale. That always happens, but I just love the quality. I actually have the contour shade on today with the blush, and then I have my Chanel Sol to Tan de Chanel underneath it all. But all in all, really great quality. Just really love this. I'm hoping to be able to pick up another one online to put in a giveaway because I think that you guys would really like this palette. So the two next products are two lip products that I've been totally obsessing over. I did do a video on them. I will pop the link right here for you guys to check it out. It's by Pat McGrath. Now, you all know that Pat McGrath products are so super expensive. So when I seen that she started to pop out like these little mini sets, I was like, okay, let's get them $32. I'm happy with that price, especially because you're getting three products. Out of the three, these are the two that I love the most. These are the Lust Glosses. And they're so, so gorgeous. This one here is the one that I'm wearing today, and it's called Dare to Bear. And this is the other one here that I love, which is called Pale Fire Nectar. This here is just the beautiful pinky nudie shade. It is so gorgeous on the lips. So, so comfortable. They glide on really nice. In the video, in the review video, I did say that I love the applicator because this applicator is really soft and it's like plushy and it just glides on the gloss so nice. Really, really comfortable. They are not tacky. They are not sticky. They are just all around a beautiful formula. And this shade here, Pale Fire Nectar, I really, really love because it has these beautiful, like, kind of pinky golds in them. And it's just all around really, really gorgeous. Once again, beautiful applicator as well. So today I'm wearing this one with a Wet n Wild lip liner. But all in all, great quality. If you guys love glosses, you definitely should pick these up because you do get a total of three glosses for $32. And it, like I said, if you want to check out that video, I'll have the link there for you guys to check it out just to see how they applied. But I love them. So two eyeliners that I've been using a lot. One is the Milk Longwear Gel Eyeliner in the shade Boss, which is this beautiful black shade right here. This is a wind-up eyeliner. Really love it. And it also comes with a little smudger, but I don't use the smudger. But these are amazing. I actually did a mini Sephora haul. We'll have the link there for you guys to check it out. And they just glide onto the waterline. So beautiful. I do have it on my top and lower waterline. Amazing, amazing quality, really super pigmented as you could tell. And I've been also loving the ColourPop, and this is the cream gel liner in Piggy Bank. Of course, it is purple. I recently did a ColourPop haul video as well. I will have that link for you guys to check it out. This is beautiful. Did a look with this, loved it, and it just stayed in the waterline so well. Didn't move. Two of these just stay there in place all day long. Really great quality, super pigmented. This is like $7, this is like $26, so quite a big difference. So if you want to try a really good, inexpensive cream gel liner before you try this one, I would definitely recommend the ColourPop gel cream liners because they are amazing. But two of these have been my go-tos. So I have two brushes and then that's it. Then we're done. The first brush here is by e.l.f. Cosmetics and it's the concealer brush. Love taking this. Love taking my concealer, applying it to my lid, and I love going right in underneath my brow bone. It really cleans it up. And then this one here is by Sigma and it's the Large Angle Contour Brush number F40, which I really love it, and it just really cuts your contour so, so gorgeous. Really soft and smooth as well. So you guys, that's it for my February favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments down below what products have been your February favorites. Is there any products that I mentioned that you guys been using that you're loving as well? Let me know in those comments down below. Really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye.